It's hard to shake the public out of its apathy. When there are public hearings affecting the community, most people don't even bother to go. When there's a cleanup drive, the great silent majority watches the operation with an appreciative nod. But if you change the garbage ordinances, you're met with a storm of protest ranging from letters to the editor all the way up to recall petitions to kick councilmen out of office. Today is the last day for sanctioned use of the venerable old garbage can with its dents and its noise and its nasty odor. From now on, Fort Worth residents are supposed to use nice, shiny, odor-free plastic bags. That's all. Nothing else changes. If you now have your garbage picked up in the alley, it'll still be picked up there. If you're required to put it by the curb, that's where you'll place your neatly tied bags. But no, you cry. What about spillage? Well, what about animals clawing the bags to shreds? What about scatter all over your lawn? Well, City Public Works Director Jack Graham says, no sweat.
Well, as you know, Jay, we've been on a voluntary bag basis for the past 18 months. And the spillage has actually been reduced over what it was when people were using garbage cans, oftentimes without lids, and generally exposed to the outside at all times where they were subject to being turned over by stray animals.
Jack Graham says that a study in New York City shows that things stay neater and cleaner when plastic bags are used. Of course, New York publishing a garbage report is like Jack the Ripper writing a book on morality. You tend to distrust the conclusions. At any rate, Fort Worth is ordering garbage bags at the rate of 20 million a year. They'll be on sale at fire stations and at City Hall. So after today, the noble garbage can clanks away into the sunset.